whenever I see those stripes,
we gotta make that happen.
We're on our way to go to the UN High Commissioner press conference. But our main goal is to be on a plane tomorrow, no later than tomorrow, to Ampeche, no matter what. We're considering driving, if necessary, across the desert for 17 hours. But that is our goal, and we are going to make it happen one way or another. And for those of you who know I'm afraid to fly, no one would ever think that I was desperate to get on a plane.
The main thing is getting on a plane to the refugee camps, which is why we came here. We want to go out there and be with them at a time when things are getting more difficult.
I have a copy.
The reason of this visit is to clearly demonstrate our solidarity and our commitment. Solidarity and commitment with the refugees, with the Chadian displaced persons in Eastern Chad, and with the Chadian people in general, in this difficult moment in which 230,000 refugees, more than 90,000 displaced Chadians are suffering the impact of insecurity, with their life being threatened, with their conditions being, of course, much more difficult than the ones that they had in their communities of origin.
To keep engaged in the protection and support to the Darfurian refugees in the east and the Central African Republic refugees in the south, and also with the 90,000 Chadians that have been forced to flee their homes because of inter-ethnic conflict and the effects of what we could call gender-based groups. A very important discussion is taking place, namely in the Security Council, about the possibility of a presence of a multidimensional nature in Eastern Chad and in Northern Central African Republic. UNHCR has been clearly advocating in favor of that presence, trying to create better security conditions for refugees, for displaced people, for the civilian populations. And Darfur is, to a certain extent, the epicenter of an earthquake whose waves create all these troubles in the countries around, in Darfur, in Chad, in Central African Republic, and in other countries. But now the situation is more complex. And there was a proposal coming from the Chadian government in order to study the possibility to relocate the refugee camps to some 500 or 600 kilometers away from the border in areas that are environmentally rather complicated. We had a mission of the Chadian government together with WFP and the UNHCR. We have been studying those locations, studying the possibilities, and I hope that in the near future we will come with a clear idea about what is possible, what is not possible. In any case, it will represent a major improvement in security if possible, but also an enormous challenge, because we are speaking about relocation of 220,000 people in the middle of a desertic or semi-desertic area and with a few hundred kilometers in between. So it's really something that needs to be very well thought, very well prepared and planned, and implemented only in conditions of safety and dignity, which it is also necessary to guarantee. It is, in any case, a very important project that we have now, as I said, on the table, studying together with the government and WFP what is the best way to go ahead. Merci.
Merci.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Shukra.
So bus, it takes 17 hours. How long does it take if you take a private car?
Private car can take less than this.
It's been a frustrating day. It's strange because it's been so interesting. You know, I mean, we were in a press conference with Antonio Guterres. Mm. You know, any other day would have been perfect, but just the stress of not being able to get out of N'Djamena.
I feel for the first time, I feel really anxious. You know, I felt so on point and so, like, our purpose was so clear, and I feel like I just feel stuck. I feel really trapped.
So now the decision to make is whether we go ahead and drive, find a car, and make it all the way from where we are, which is Western Chad, cross the desert and make it all the way to Eastern Chad, which would be probably around a 15-hour road trip.
Yeah.
Thank you.